the second part of this exercise, we have to implement in the chiller alarm project the strategy and the mask also we wrote in the original chiller project. We can start here in the strategy. In this case, the easiest, fastest, and most convenient way to implement the strategy is to export and import the POW or the POWs of the chiller project. So we abandon for a while the project template, open again the chiller, the previous chiller project, and we can here in the resource we can export POW. This project has two POWs, tempreg, that is a program POW, this one, and stage4direct, that is a function block POW, this one. So we have to select the POW that we need to export. We have to export tempreg, and you can see that the system automatically selects the other. Why? Because tempreg uses the function block stage4direct, so that the system automatically selects it and prevent to disable it. Well, we have to save into a file. Okay, doesn't matter the name. We can save in a place easy to find. Okay, this is one of the previous exercises. Okay, override yes. Now we can reopen the chiller alarms. We can do the opposite, that is import POW. It was in the desktop chiller P1. This is an issue regarding the version of the libraries, the current basic lib library used in the source and destination project. Now, just to simplify, we can just continue. Anyway, this issue is explained in a specific document regarding the libraries. Now we can just accept. Here are the two POW that are inside the file. These are the options. We can import with a different name or dot import. In this case, the default option is import. This is what we need, because we need both the POW. Okay. So here are these are the POW of the original chiller alarms or project template, if you prefer, and this one are the two POWs that have been imported. Well, we can try to build and check if there are errors. May occur some errors. Let's see if today I'm lucky and I have that error. Here is the error. Is I have double clicked the message, is here. So what's wrong with this strategy? It worked before in the chiller project. It worked. The problem is that this unit status is a double integer data type, while this block requires a boolean. But why before worked and now doesn't work? Because unit status is okay, it is a double integer, and it is used. We could use defined, but I already know that it is here. Unit status is this one, so it is a variable which value is in the range 1 to 7, representing the unit status. So, what is the problem here? The problem is that. Here we need a boolean variable representing the general unit status. 0 off, 1 on, or false true off on. So the variable that we need is not this, but is this one. Because in the project template, the variable representing the general, say, unit status is called unit on. So we can fix the problem changing this variable with unit on. Okay, before to build, we can fix another issue that already know. so we can save some time in this tutorial, we have to work again here, because we just saw that the unit on depends not only by the on off by keyboard like the previous chiller project, but also according to an on off by digital input, by alarm, by BMS, by scheduler. But in this exercise, in my exercise, in our exercise, these are not used. So we have to somehow disable this variable, that is they don't have they must not have effect on the unit on. So how to do this? Probably the first thing that probably also you are thinking is delete this variable, delete this block, in order to have unit on depend only by unit keyboard on off. But doing that, we have to do something also here, because we want have this variable, and so on. Moreover, maybe that in the future we will need again of this variable. If next month the customer asks for the on off by alarm or on off by scheduler, we would need to implement that strategy again. So, in my opinion, the fastest way to fix the problem is simply force these values to a variable, oh, sorry, to a value corresponding to unit is on. So in this case could be, can add a variable, the value is true, like this. If remember, a straight connection between a constant or a variable to a variable corresponds to a move, that is this value is copied inside this variable. So runtime, the digital input on off, we take the value true, so that it won't have effect in the end block. So the same, so copy, duplicate, duplicate, duplicate. We have to change this, because since here there is the not, we have to force to false. False, this is false, not becomes true, and so on. So these four variables are forced to a value that correspond to the unit that can start by digital input, by alarm, by BMS, and so on. Okay, now we can build and check if there are other errors. I don't expect other errors. Okay, this asks to build again. I will do it. Well, no errors, so we can continue with the mask. For the mask, we can take a different approach, because okay, also in this case we could export import the worksheet from the chiller project and import here in the chiller alarms, but in that case we would need also to move a lot of mask across the loop. Probably we have to also to move some object inside the mask somewhere else in the structure of chill template. At the end, in this case is more convenient to write everything from scratch regarding the user interface. So we can start from the status of input and output. We already have a mask, a main mask. That could be a good place where to show the temperature and the status of the compressor. So we can rename this text with the water inlet temperature. We can add another text like in the very original, very first exercise. So the four compressors on the same line, and here beside the variable water inlet temperature, we can reduce the number of values to, and here below the status of the four compressors, so variable press one. And compressor 4. Input and output. Now unit status is already implemented. Next are the operating parameters, set point and differential. We can use the quick menu for set point. This is the mask. So we can rename this to set point. Okay, also set was good. Set point and differential or proportional band, whatever S, two variables, set point, proportional band, only two integer figures, here, only one. So also set point is okay. What's next? The configuration parameter, the enable of compressor 1, 2, 3, 4. In this case we can use one of the existing menu. We saw before that there is start. There are some generic menu, so we can use one of these for our target, that is where to place the four variables to enable the four compressors. We can use the last one. Why? Because we already have the icon of the compressor here. While if we used the first one, we would need to change also the icon. So I will use the third menu, the one for device N. So stop, the menu is here, the loop, the corresponding loop is here. Device N, I can change the name because I don't like the default name. Configuration, I can change also the loop name. Loop configuration. Okay, now I can fill with text. Compressor 1. Okay. And the variable en comp 1. Quickly duplicate, copy, paste, 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 and change the text here and the variable here, and the same for the other two. Well, now what we will see here in these variables, in these classes, 0, 1, off, on, no, yes, disable, enable, whatever else. We could use the preview value for that, so click this. We could see 0, 1, so there is any resource to use on bool here. So in order to fix this and easily see something more meaningful here, for example, no, yes, we can use the resource used on bool, not at class level, because we had to create a new class, and it takes a little, but since in this mask there are only boolean variables, it is faster to use the resource used on bool property at mask level. So no, yes, as usual, if you prefer you can use the support dialog box. You can rename the title compressors, something like that. Last point is the description of the menu. There is another mistake. The variable device n doesn't exist. Why? Double click, it brings on the error. So go to loop, device n doesn't exist. Why? Because I rename to loop configuration. The description of this menu is not the best, it's still a generic description, device N, would be better to rename it to compressors. So how to do this? I repeat once again that in the user manual, it is described also the project template, like in this case how to edit the menu. So this is the online help, always updated, so enter. Open the main menu, the project template is here in the library, in the project template, menu management. So editing a menu, so we can go straight to what we need. To edit a main menu, we have to edit these classes, main text top, middle, bottom, and also the class IDXEMGMain. These classes are this one, and also this one. So this one is the one for the images. We don't have to change because we saw before that the image is already correct, is the icon of the compressor. So we have to change this. Is this one is main txt top bottom middle. It is a class, so open the classes main top. We have to change the resource used on int. In the previous exercise we used the resource used on bool for boolean variables. Int is for integer, is obvious. Said that we have only two entries, we have more than two. So we have to rename device N with compressors. I copy this because I need in the other two. Copy. And then edit middle. Paste. And then also the bottom. Paste. Ok, so menu, compressors, okay, change correctly, here are the enable of the four compressors, okay, change also here the watch. Well, also the mask should be correct, so the configuration parameter, we have the input and output, unit status, and the settings. What is missing? Is missing the C design, because we have created a new project based on project template, but C design is almost empty, so we have to update also it. So stop, we can start C design from here. You can see that C design of the project template has just one configuration, so we can I think it's easier. Also here we could export import from the other, but probably is better to repeat from scratch, so it is a good opportunity to repeat how C design works. So let's delete this configuration. I create a new configuration, CPico, because I'm using a CPico, chiller for comp. In the chiller application we have created two configurations, chiller 2 comps and chiller for comps. Now just to speed up the exercise, I will create the one for compressors. Here is next input output. So U1 is temperature, it is another input, NTC sensor. Here is in the other side we have compressor 1, compressor 2, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay. Well, we don't need to edit the mask wizard because we have used the full mask editor, CMask. So we can go straight and update into the controller. At the connection, this is the only Pico that I have here, so upload. Okay. Well, now this is the project running in the real controller, unit off by keyboard, quick menu on off, switch on the unit. Unit is on, but compressors are off even if the temperature is very high. Why? Probably because of two things. The first is the parameters. So let's go to the setting, quick menu, in fact. 4. Compressor still off. Why? Okay, the only other reason is the enable of the compressor. Not too fast. So menu compressors. Let's enable the first one. I don't know if you hear the relay that I switched on. This is the second. Infatti we have two compressors on. The third. The fourth. Oh. And here are all the compressors on. Well, so we have re-implemented exporting, importing part of the code or rewriting from scratch, implemented all the strategy of the original chiller application. This is all for this for the second part of the exercise, for this tutorial. In the next tutorial we will start managing the alarms.